Hello friends, this video on playing with numbers part 5 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So based on whatever we have studied so far on factors and multiples, let us see what did we conclude, because there were certain important things that we knew about factors and multiples. Now a factor has to be an exact divisor of the number. Only then it becomes a factor of that number. So you think of any example. So let's think of this example 4. So who would be a multiple of 4? Only that number which divides 4 exactly, leaving 0 as remainder. For example, 1 would be an exact divisor, 2 would be an exact divisor, 4 itself would be an exact divisor. So 1, 2 and 4 would be the factors of number 4. 1 is a factor of every number. Now if you want, you can just observe it for yourself. So let us take 4. So what are the factors of 4? 4 can be written as 1 into 4, it can be written as 2 into 2, it can be written as 4 into 1. Now when we write 4 as 2 into 2, it basically means that 2 exactly divides 4, where the other two would be quotient and the remainder would be 0. Similarly, when you divide 4 by 4, the quotient would be 1 and the remainder would be 0. So considering these, we find that 1, 2 and 4 are factors of 4. Similarly, think of a number like 8. So 8 can be written as 1 into 8, 2 into 4, 4 into 2, 8 into 1. So basically looking at these, you can say 1, 2, 4, 8 are the factors of 8. Now did you notice something? That 1 is common for both of them. In fact, you consider any number, you consider 13, you consider 59, you consider 100. Everywhere you would see that 1 is a factor, because 1 divides every number. Every number is a factor of itself. Now that is also another interesting fact, that 4 is a factor of 4, 8 is a factor of 8, 13 is a factor of 13, 59 is a factor of 59, and so on. So basically 1 and the number itself, these two factors will be there for every number. A factor is always less than or equal to the number. So that is also very much evident, because who would be a factor? An exact divisor. So that exact divisor has to be less than the number itself, or at the max it can be equal to the number. So you see, for 4, the factors are either less than 4, like 1 and 2, or equal to 4. Similarly for 8, the factors are either less than 8, like 1, 2 and 4, or it is equal to 8. A number has finite number of factors. Finite means fixed number of or limited number of factors. So if you consider this number 4, so how many factors number 4 has? 1, 2 and 4. So basically it has 3 factors. You think of number 8, how many factors it has? 1, 2, 3, 4. So it has 4 factors. And these number of factors remain constant. So 4 cannot have more than 3 factors. These are the only possible factors for 4. So for every number you have a finite number of factors. Now when we come to the multiples, we see that every number is a multiple of itself. Now that is one very interesting fact, that every number is a factor of itself and every number is also a multiple of itself. Now let us look at an example. Let us consider the number 4. And let us try to write its multiples. So these would be the multiples of 4. So basically what do you see? That the multiples start with the number itself. So if it is 4, 4 when multiplied by 1 is 4 itself. And that is which property of whole number is this? Can you recall from the previous lesson? It is nothing but multiplicative identity. 1 is called the multiplicative identity because when you multiply 1 to any number, the number remains the same. And that is the reason why 4 is a multiple of itself, because 4 when multiplied by 1 gives the number itself. That is, it gives 4. A multiple is always more than or equal to the number. So that's another interesting thing, because when we were talking about factors, we were actually trying to divide the number. by their factors. But when we talk about multiples, we try to multiply the numbers. So you see, in order to find the multiples, what are we doing? We are multiplying the number 4 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. But when we were trying to find factors of 4, what were we trying to do? We were trying to divide 4 by 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, and then try to find out where the remainder is 0. So since here we are multiplying, so it is quite obvious that the value of the multiples would be more than that of the number, or at least it would be equal to the number. So a multiple will always be more than or equal to the number. A number has infinite number of multiples, as you can see here, that the count of these natural numbers starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on, this would continue till infinity. So you might reach a number where you are actually trying to multiply 4 by infinity. So what would you get? You would get infinity. So basically the number of multiples are also infinite. So you can start from 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28. So you can go on and on, and you would write infinite number of multiples of 4. Not only 4, this is true for any number. So these are some of the differences between factors and multiples. So I hope that the concept of factors and multiples are absolutely clear now. If it is not clear, please replay and watch the video again, but get your concept cleared. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple 4-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.